Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to my channel. Eat healthy, drink good beer, and get rich. Today, I have ridiculously easy dish to make. It is based upon wild salmon. This is a dish that you make if you have some friends over, if you have your boyfriend over, your girlfriend over, or you are going to your parents' house. I'll show you an absolutely easy to make marination base. I will talk about stock that I'm passionate about, and I'm also going to talk about the beer that will bring all the flavors together. For this particular dish, you need wild salmon, natural yogurt. I am using natural yogurt, but you can use fat-free one. You can use Greek yogurt. It doesn't matter as long as there's no flavoring in it. Spray olive oil, medium curry powder. This is a really important ingredient because this is going to give the color as well as the taste. We have black pepper, we have cumin seeds, we have ground coriander, ground cumin, 4 potatoes, baby potatoes per person, yellow pepper, red pepper, whatever you have in the fridge, just chuck it in. Carrots, broccoli, green beans, and onion for me and my wife. A lemon. Let's get started. Again, it really doesn't matter, guys. No rules to my cooking, okay? As long as all the salmons are coated, that should be enough. I'm gonna squeeze one lime. There are no rules. Little bit of curry powder, little bit of cumin, little bit of ground pepper, few cumin seeds, some coriander, ground cumin, olive oil, salt, and always try to add a little less because you can always add salt later. Okay, so let's, the way I marinate these will be just tilt them like that. Don't be scared to use your hands. Just mix everything together. You can use a spoon, but I prefer to use my hands. This is wild salmon, guys, okay? So I don't like to eat farmed salmon. The reason is because most of the offshore farms, there are large farms and the excreta goes down to the ocean and destroys the ocean. And oceans, as you all know, they feed the life on the planet. Yes, this is really, really expensive. We just eat it maybe once a month. So this is all done. I have just put a cling film, and this will rest for about 3 to 4 hours at room temp. You can also marinate it overnight in the fridge. You can cook straight from the fridge, no problem, but I like to bring the meat to room temperature. It's time to introduce the beer of the day. It's Lef, again, it's from Belgium. Last week, I introduced you a Belgian beer called Duvel. It is slightly lighter than Duvel, but I love this beer and I cannot wait to taste this beer with cooked salmon. You can use a white wine which is not so dry. Any white wine will work, any Chardonnay, Cabernet Sauvignon will do the job. So let's cut these vegetables. I'm just gonna season it with salt, pepper, cumin, and black pepper. I have added a little bit of olive oil, but most of it is the spray olive oil. This is just gonna go in. Once this butter melts, I'm gonna give it a quick mix, and it should cook automatically in 20-25 minutes. Most of this stuff is edible on its own. We just need to make sure that we cook broccoli a little bit more. And I am boiling the potatoes. You can cook the potatoes within the same tray, but they need a head run, so maybe cook 15-20 minutes and then mix everything together. But I'm just, the tray is already full, so I'm just boiling them. This goes in at 220 degrees for 15-20 minutes, and I'll mix one or two times. The vegetables have been cooking for 15 minutes. I have occasionally mixed them. I have placed all the salmons like that, so you never pack in meat when you're cooking it, just so that the heat goes everywhere. If it is a one pot recipe, however, I am boiling potatoes on the side. You can add those potatoes back into this tray if you want, but I'm not going to do it because it's just already too crowded vegetable wise. I always like to have more vegetables than meat in my diet. This remaining sauce is going to go up on the top and it will go in for 15-20 minutes. It is okay for 15 minutes, depending upon the size of the salmon, If you cook a little bit more, it's fine. As I've been saying to you in my previous videos, a little bit extra is fine. Don't worry about it.
The stock I wanted to talk to you today is one of my invest and forget stock. I still consider it penny stock because it is still under 10 pounds. But everyone has different definition of penny stock. For me, it's still a penny stock. And for students, three or four Costa coffees. So again, I nibble at this stock a lot. By the way, ARK Invest also is buying into this stock. So if ARK Invest is nibbling, I'll nibble too. The amount of people they have on their disposal to do due diligence is just incredible. However, a part of the reason why I invest in this stock is because they produce genetically engineered salmon. The stock, it's at 934 at the moment. So it's a better way to raise Atlantic salmon. We are cooking salmon today. So obviously I did everything deliberately. The farm salmon sometimes also escapes, wrecking havoc in native populations. So what these guys are doing is they have genetically engineered the salmon. So the wild salmon takes 3 years to grow properly, whereas this salmon actually grows in 13, 14 months. This salmon also has good protein content. I don't know if you know, but the farm salmon has high fat content as compared to the wild salmon. The financials of this company are looking really good. Yes, they have diluted shareholders recently, but they have 40 million, I think 38 to 40 million in cash, out of which 10 million is their liabilities, 2 million is outstanding, I think in 12 months. It's ethically farmed salmon. There is some insider buying. They already have two plants in US and Canada, and they have the cash in hand to make a third plant and maybe possibly expand into Europe. Because of the amount of cash in hand, I think cash is king. So I am pretty confident that they will deliver this plant and achieve profitability in 1 or 2 years time. There's nothing stopping them from genetically engineering other seafood, shrimp and other things. I am a big fan of seafood, but it's just very, very expensive. If you look at their website, and I told you about salmon escaping, and also the excreta destroying the ocean, they have these tanks. So I am really ethically driven to invest in this company. I am not a financial advisor. This video is for entertainment purposes only. Stock markets are risky. You may lose all the money. So please do your own due diligence. Biggest trends for next 5 years is renewable energy. EV markets and saving the planet. Anything that does that will be really hot, in my opinion. We only have one planet to live. Ultimately, at some point, we have to leave this planet and find a new one. But until that time, there is only one planet in the universe that we know that life is possible. So we have to do something about this. People worry about the word GM. But let me tell you something. Let's start with the vegetables.
Do you think this carrot is natural? Google how wild carrots look. Do you think this is natural broccoli? Humans made broccoli from mustard. It is result of centuries of crossbreeding. When someone says to you, life gave you lemons and you make lemonade, just say that saying is shite, because humans made lemons by crossing citrus oranges. Your pets, have a look at your dog or your cat. That's all genetic engineering. Genetic modification. When you hear the word GM, don't be so scared, okay? It's all around you. Have a look at the pictures of wild dogs and then compare it to your pet and you'll understand. This is almost done. I did glaze it a little bit with this, my friend, light fry. So 1 calorie spray each. Salmon is really, really good for you. It contains the long chain omega acids. It contains many antioxidants. It is really, really healthy for you. I don't have to explain the health benefits of all the vegetables. So time to serve it. Okay guys, I like to give it a little bit drizzle of lemon. I have used the juices at the bottom to coat these potatoes with those juices. This is one of the most healthiest dish
you can ever get on the planet. Now, if you like my content, please, please, please like, subscribe, hit that bell button so that next time I make a video, you get notifications. You can, if you are a big fan of vitamin C, vitamin C is in the peppers. However, you can add jalapenos. I hope I said that correct, Pepe Sanchez. I was once, I had some work in America and I landed in San Jose. At the airport, the officer said to me, "Where are you going?" And I said, "San Jose." He started laughing at me. He said, no, mate, it's San Jose. I said, all right, that's fine. Then he said, "How long are you gonna stay in America?" And I said, "From Hanuri to Hula." Time for a taste test. The way you can know that the salmon is cooked is if your knife goes into the salmon pretty easy. The salmon tastes naturally very well. All we have done is slightly enhanced its taste. I want to see whether this beer goes well with the salmon. Try this combo, guys, and let me know in the comments if you have tried this recipe. Also, your thoughts on Aqua Bounty.